Tom, tough game and a 4-2 loss. What do you take from the game?
The positives? I don't know, to be honest, right now. I'm sure I'll find some through the week. I thought we worked hard, but I thought we struggled to break them down. I thought their neutral zone was excellent, and we didn't really get much penetration into the end zone at the front of the net. And I don't think, obviously, we got enough scoring opportunities. And it was 12 minutes into the third period before we really got our first scoring opportunity. I thought defensively we were pretty good, except for the fact that we gave them a two-goal start, and that's where I'm hurting a little bit. We gave two real cheap goals away, to be honest.
The guys showed some character to come back, put it up to level scores.
Yeah, I thought we showed a lot of character. We won the second period, and that was certainly our best period of the hockey game. I was disappointed that when we scored our two goals, our second goal, we then gave up a goal the next shift, and that's a little bit of concentration. And I think we probably got the wrong matchup there. We got our third unit up against their top line, and it was obviously a hard shift for those guys to handle. You know, Backlick's a very good player, and complimented very well by Pliskauskas, so they are hard to handle. But that's experience for our young players. You know, that's what you're up against. That's the type of player that you've got to play against to play a regular shift in this league.
And another two goals from Karpov. Looking to next season, you know, kind of obviously that's the kind of player I assume you'd want to keep. What kind of chances do you think we've got of retaining players of that kind of calibre?
At this moment in time, not really sure. Of course, if I was here myself, I'd love to keep Thomas. And there's a lot of guys in that dressing room, but Thomas has come in and he's added a lot to the team. You know, he gives us that first line centre. He gives us that go-to player who is, you know, a franchise player, if you like. He scores big goals, he makes big plays, he handles a lot of ice time, and you know, it's really improved our power play. So there's a lot goes through Thomas on the ice, but you know, that first power play unit for us has been very, very good, and they carry a lot of weight for the team.
And then finally, just at the end, there was kind of quite a lot of anger towards the officials from some of the supporters. What's your take on the officials and the kind of influence of tonight's game, but also the league in general?
I think the officials have always got a hard job. You know, I don't think I'd want to be an official, and I don't think many guys in the stands would want to be an official. They're going to miss things. You know, it does get frustrating, no more so from the players. Generally, all in all, you know, I don't like to criticise officials too much, but I think he missed a couple today, a couple of off-the-puck incidents perhaps, and I think that was what was frustrating. I think what we have, what, one power play through the course of the game, so... You know, there was probably a couple more out there, but across the season, you know, generally I've been pretty pleased with the level of officiating. Yes, it goes up and down. Yes, it's inconsistent. One night you might have three officials out there, and one night you might have four. So, from a player's perspective, that's, you know, it changes the game a little bit. It changes the dynamic of what's happening. You've got referees in the neutral zone calling penalties, you know, on a four-man system, or you've got referees down low in the corner. So, you know, the consistency is always a factor in refereeing, and you know, it's not their fault. But I think the league need to sort out whether they're running with a four-man system or whether they're running with a three-man.